Hello and welcome back. My name is Srinivas, and today instead of talking about something related to AWS and technologies and infrastructure as code, let's talk between you and me, and let's try and speak through what we are actually trying to do with this channel. I am actually having a vision regarding what to do and how to proceed with this channel, right? So by now you may have seen some of my videos. I hope you have seen some of my videos. I really would appreciate if you could like and subscribe some of those videos. It would be great. And what I'm trying to do here is this video is what I'm gonna use as a way to explain what you can expect from this channel, right, going forward. So what I'm trying to do here is, some of the videos you may have seen is where we talk about going through hands-on training, as we can see on the screen here. It's like, okay, we have hands-on training from AWS. It's a 10-minute tutorial. It's the cost to try that tutorial and work through that tutorial is, if you all you need is a free tier AWS account and beginner level experience, and you set up a hello world lambda function here, which is going to be used to try and test and learn and understand certain things, right? So you will and should expect some of those kind of videos going forward from me. And what I would continue to do is I'll continue to go through these tutorials. And most likely in the initial phases, it would be beginner tutorials. And they would be connected to each other on a pattern. That's the second phase and the second part of the process, what I'm gonna do, right? That is what I'll disclose to you right now. It's like, once we start doing these processes, like as in this example, what we're doing here is we are having a serverless function and we are setting that up, right? But at the same time, I want to run and go through a process of building a real world application. I may have said that in the past, so this is where I disclose it to you. This is more like a sneak peek of the architecture diagram of the application that I'm planning on deploying, designing, and having it running in AWS, right? This is more like a food order application where you order us from your preferred vendor or from wherever you want to order, and it goes and processes that order, and it does sending emails and notifications, it does order processing, it does authentication, it has multiple queues, it will be having a data store, which would be data backend where the order files, or it would be converted to PDF in this case, and it would be stored. And it would have a database where all the data related to that specific order would be residing in, right? So it's a very elaborate application. And to build an application like that, there is building blocks required to make that successful. Like as an example, we have some of these functions, like order food systems would be a Lambda function. So that is this building block that we just discussed right now, which is, okay, we are gonna go through a Hello World app example, and then we are gonna try and understand Lambda functions and then apply that to a real world Lambda function application. Like, now, how would we proceed with deploying a Lambda function? It would not be on a console for sure. I can guarantee you that part. So we would be using infrastructure as code services. In this case, my preferred tool is Terraform in this case, and I'll be using that to deploy or create modules that would help deploy multiple services, and then we'll try and do the release phase using different technologies inside AWS space for the most part. And the eventual goal for me to with this application that I'm going to scale the build is to try and tier the application. What I mean by tier is, okay, this is an application that is ready, that is available, it's ready to be deployed. Okay, it's deployed. All right, now we have customer A using it, right? Now, as an example, right? Now we want to add more customers to the application. That's what you write code for usability. And they would be having different requirements in this case. In this case, it would be like, okay, I want my data to be in a different database. As against to, I'm okay with the entry point for your endpoints or the services. I'm okay with sharing that entry point, but my data needs to reside exclusively in a different database. It has to reside in a different data store, for that example. And in certain cases, in this case, I'm going to use two queues, and Kafka is a queuing system that I'm probably going to use for traversing some of that information. And in this case, there might be a real world scenario where someone or some end user of the application would say, okay, and with that Kafka use case, what I'm planning on doing is we'll move a part of the two queues into batch processing. So instead of that, somebody would have a requirement saying, okay, we need that to be more like for like, because like every single request needs to be processed. It may come at a different tier of pricing, but we need to proceed with that and we need to deploy that. So that needs to be handled in an automated fashion as well. All three use cases that we discussed, where somebody needs the same entry point and data stores might be unique and might be isolated. There might be queuing systems might have different requirements that might be a different use case for different end users. And the third use case in this case would be like, okay, I have an entirely separate application deployed as well. So those all that's the, like a proliferation of your in infrastructure, and it just starts scaling out quickly and getting deployed quickly. And managing that infrastructure is a challenge in itself, right? So that would be the next phase of this process, where I'll try and do that in a more like a infrastructure as code fashion, where all those kind of use cases would be managed, and we'll start doing that by doing the building blocks first. One of the building blocks that we talked about is a set of videos like Lambda functions. The other ones would be that we would start doing the building blocks for setting up this system itself. Like as an example, we'll have this data store, right? Data store, and then we'll have Lambda functions here. They will reside in the VPC. So as another sneak peek, we'll have another separate video about this. We'll do a separate video about VPCs as well. I have this module that has been written that does Terraform and it deploys VPCs. And what it does is it takes four inputs and it creates three AZ per type of subnets, and it just creates an entire VPC and all the requirements for that VPC upfront. So that would be kind of a base requirement to make that function and make the system work, or like that would be the place where we'll deploy our application. That would be the VPC itself. Another thing going forward would be like, okay, we need to create something similar like this for authentication system, right? Something similar like this for deploying all the Lambda functions. Something similar like this for our entry points, which would be ALBs, or it would be API gateways, one of the two. And so I'll start doing the building blocks part of that. And that would be the second part of the videos on this channel. Well, we'll start looking into the technology itself. We'll start looking into some sort of hands-on training on using that technology, which we just saw as Hello World as an example for Lambda functions. And similar to that, we'll start using infrastructure as code and start writing that code system so that it can be scaled to our needs. And in this case, we'll try and make it more dynamic as possible. So that would be another set of videos that we should expect on this channel. So hopefully this was a good introduction and like setting the groundwork for all the things that we're going to do in the near future on this channel. And I hope that is very interesting to you, and you would come back for more videos like these, or more videos like in-depth videos of some of the things that we discussed here. So please like and subscribe and hit the bell notification icon so that you can be notified about new videos as they come out. Thank you so much and have a wonderful day.